Nuttyitonline.com/livewire.
Well, guess who we got on the phone right now?
Who?
His sexting buddy, Sydney Leathers.
Ooh. Oh, she's on the phone.
Sydney, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Oh, hey, thank you for being had.
Thank you for, yeah.
Hustler Club this weekend. We know you're heading to the Hustler Club. You're going to be doing a performance. What exactly do you do? You weren't a dancer prior to the whole dust up with you and Weiner. So what
no,
do you do?
I'm not dancing on Saturday. I'm just hosting, really.
Okay. Now, at any point, do you get nude?
Not this Saturday, but maybe in the future.
Maybe wear something scantily clad?
Obviously, if anyone is that interested in seeing me nude, they can go to vividcelebs.com.
Yeah.
Great point.
Check out Weiner and me.
Yeah, this kind of snowballed very quickly. You were sexting with Anthony Weiner, and
yes.
There were some dirty pictures that went around, and then now you're on film, correct? Doing all sorts of naughty stuff. That happened very quickly.
Yes, it did. It's been a whirlwind, to say the least.
Because there was one video, it was just you solo. Is there another one with you and a gentleman?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, that's Weiner and me, and
of course it is.
When you go to Vivid Celeb right now.
When's the last time you spoke to Anthony Weiner?
In April of this year.
What was the last text that he sent you? What did it say?
Actually, oddly enough, the last thing we talked about was the Netflix series House of Cards.
Not hot. Not hot
dull,
at all.
Right?
I was going to say, though. Did he ever send anything, I mean, that was to the point of like, okay, this is like Japanese businessman disgusting?
No. That bad, but I mean, just getting the pictures in general was surprising considering he'd been through the first scandal already, and I never asked him for photos, so like he really wanted to show
off.
Yeah,
it's like a rush. He gets one of them weird. I always say those guys in power, they get that weird rush when they, you know, they do naughty stuff like that.
Yeah, I think he's impulsive, and I think it's an adrenaline thing, and maybe like the thrill of not getting caught or trying not to get caught anyway.
Did he ever say, you know, did you know it was him from the beginning? And
I always knew it was him from day one. He didn't make the little Carlos Danger email until he started to send me the explicit photos. That's what that was for.
So did he tell you, look, don't, you got to keep this on the down low?
You know, he never flat out said it like that, but he would kind of try to guilt trip me as, oh, look at what these other women did to me in the first scandal. Isn't it terrible? That type of thing. But he was never like, oh, please keep your mouth shut.
Did you ever tell him that
But I will say at one time he did say that if I deleted all of our chats, he would get me a job at Politico.
Oh, wow.
Did you ever tell him that you wouldn't say anything, like don't worry about it? Did you ever say, I would never do that?
Yeah, because at that time, I really felt that way.
And then what happened? And then you just told everybody.
Yeah, I mean, what happened was I tried to leak everything anonymously, and then I was being very naive, obviously, and then my name got out there within, I don't know, 2 days.
You listening,
so.
Guys?
So what was the motive?
You listening?
What was the motive? Yeah, exactly. Guys, if she says you can't,
it's
you can't trust
between us.
Yeah.
But what was the motive with the leaking? Why?
Well, he was number one in the polls, and it really was irritating me that he was going on all of these interviews and trying to act like the first scandal was the only thing he ever did wrong, and he had rehabilitated himself. And even just this week, he was on Sean Hannity Wednesday, and he tried to totally dismiss the second scandal like the first one is the only one that happened, and I'm living proof that that is not true. So he keeps continuing this lie. I think he thinks that if he continues to lie, suddenly we'll believe him, but it's not the case.
Were you ever worried that, you know, because he's a government guy or running for office, that he might have some type of power to hurt you or your career or, you know, I mean, back in the day, people like you went missing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I never personally was concerned about that, but I know people on Twitter are always like, oh, you're going to end up dead in a ditch.
Jeez,
you know?
Oh, my God. Christ.
He's going to kill you off. I do hear that from people online, but that's not really a fear of mine. I'm pretty sure if I ended up dead in a ditch, everyone would know who did it.
I saw him walking around New York, and he's a broken man. I live in New York, and I see him walking, taking the subway all the time, and he's so sad looking now. I feel bad.
Well, that makes me feel terrible. Aw.
Yeah, he's very sad.
You
I mean,
sound
you did, you
crazy busted
life.
Up about it.
Yeah,
Sydney Leathers.
No, really, I do. I don't want him to be like devastated or like heartbroken or anything. But I mean, it's not like he was. You know, I'm not completely to blame for everything.
How long? When did this break? What, Josh? What, or Sydney? When did this really start to catch steam?
Again, we're talking to Sydney
July,
Leathers, Hustler Club, this Saturday, Baltimore. hustlerclub.com for more information.
Yeah, Sydney Leather. She was sexting with Anthony Weiner. So in July, August, September, October, here we are, 4 months. This has been, I mean, you went from sexting with a mayoral candidate to now doing full hardcore porn in 4 months. Where is the next 4 months headed? I mean, you work very quickly.
I mean, who knows? Snuff. I would like to do radio. There's a lot of different things I would like to do.
Oh, so you think you could just do this now because you can sext?
Actually, I have experience in radio.
Oh,
really? I used to sext a program director and said, if I don't get weekend shifts, I'm telling your wife.
Yeah, right. Is that what you're going to do?
No, I think I can do without the sexting and can get a job on my own.
What kind of experience do you have? I never knew you were a Sydney Leathers had radio experience.
May have an opening.
Yeah, I was involved with the Radio Information Service for like 8.5 years, which is a service for blind and print handicapped people. So it was mostly news programs. And
oh, you can do news?
Yeah.
Oh, there's going to be an opening here pretty soon.
Stop it. Oh, come on. We made you stand and read some headlines with hot chicks around you. That's Robert Kelly would love that.
No, I wouldn't. Not now. I wouldn't. I'd die. I would. If I had to do what he did, I would have died. Yeah.
Just flat out died.
Sydney Leathers, Baltimore Hustler Club, Larry Flynn's Hustler Club. Again, go to BaltimoreHustlerClub.com. You're going to be hosting the weekend, all right? Not dancing yourself.
I am going to be hosting, and also check out the film, Weiner and Me, on VividSeleb.com.
So you're on film having sex with a man, but you're not even going to take your top off this weekend?
Come on.
Not this weekend.
Come on.
Have you sexted with anybody, other guys? Are guys like scared to sex with you now?
Yeah, because you're going to blow up their spot.
You're going to rat them out.
Guys request to sex with me even more now.
Sydney's really? Going to blow their spot up. Hey, I got to ask, there was a, you know, we look at some photos of you back in July, then we look at some photos from September, and you seem you have two new additions to the family.
I do. I have two large new additions. Yes.
Yeah. When did you? Who paid for the jugs?
Weiner.
Yeah. Weiner's career.
Weiner's career paid for. Weiner's new career.
Pride.
His family.
You know what's funny about that? I had actually wanted to get a breast augmentation when I was talking to him in 2012, and he told me not to. So I guess maybe I'm being defiant now.
Oh yeah.
If you delete these, I'll get you some breastises. Please. All right, Sydney Leathers, Baltimore Hustler Club, this Saturday, tomorrow night, BaltimoreHustlerClub.com. Sydney, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
All right, take care.
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel
on 98 Rock.
98Online.com.